I'm here with Dr. Michael Zürn. He's a professor at the Social Science Research Center Berlin. Welcome at the German Development Institute. Professor Zürn, today you gave the keynote address on global governance as multi-level governance at the International Expert Workshop here at the German Development Institute. The workshop addresses the increasing institutional fragmentation of global environmental governance. You identify a number of deficiencies of global multi-level governance. Could you illustrate some of these deficiencies with regard to the ongoing financial crisis?
Well, I try to identify two major deficiencies of global governance, and one is the legitimacy issue and the other is the fragmentation issue, as you have mentioned already. With respect to the legitimacy issue, probably the best example, if we look at the financial crisis, is the moment when head of governments, especially in the Eurozone, come together, sit together overnight and essentially negotiate and commit billions of euro from the national budgets without really incorporating the national parliaments. That leads to a situation in which the parliaments essentially have then to decide very quickly, without getting enough information, whether they vote with yes or no, and they know very exactly if they vote with no, they will even make the crisis worse. So in that sense, this leads to a disempowerment to some extent of national parliaments, and that of course then creates the question, where is the legitimacy of this kind of international global governance policies? Where is the democratic legitimacy of it? So that creates this, or points to this one problem of the global governance structure as we have it today. The other one is fragmentation. Fragmentation means essentially there are many, many different issue areas, many problem areas, so to speak, which develop their policies. Some of them are also quite effective, but there is very little coordination between them. So if you look to the national political system, there are a number of institutional spots, so to speak, which are there to solve those coordination problems. There's the head of government, the chancellor, with the Richtlinienkompetenz, as we call it in German. There are the supreme courts, there's public opinion. In all those places, there are those debates about different demands from different sectors. So if there is the debate between wealth or clean environment, there is the debate between security or freedom. These are the places where public opinion comes in and where you coordinate different demands coming from different subsystems. And this is lacking on the international level almost completely. And that means that if we looked at the financial crisis, even if we have, for example, maybe in 2 or 3 years from now, a good regulation of the financial markets, may be still the case that if we look to international trade, that the trade regime creates imbalances between the United States and China, between Greece and Germany, that are essentially unbearable and would lead to a financial crisis, even if there would be a very good financial regulation. So there's this lack of coordination between those different policy areas.
Where do you see major differences regarding the effectiveness of global political institutions across policy fields? For example, among finance, which has talked about it, environmental protection and development. And what do you consider to be the main reasons for this variation?
I mean, if I would be asked to separate the different international regimes and regulations that we have in those which work very well, which are effective, and those which are less effective, I would probably say on the one hand we have those institutions which are there to create markets, which are there to make global exchange possible. For example, the international trade regime with the World Trade Organization. They are very strong, they have a very strong dispute settlement body. In that sense, those institutions, which are market-making institutions, are very strong in the realm of global governance. Those which then should correct the outcomes of those new markets, the market-correcting policies, they are sometimes quite effective as well, but in the average they are probably weaker. And that creates a sort of an imbalance that what many people call as the strategy of neoliberalism essentially means there is a more stronger place and for those institutions which liberalize, and those which regulate on the international level are there, but they are still weaker.
Finally, how can we build better and more effective institutions to secure the attainment of common goods in the realm of sustainable development?
I mean, if I would know that, I would be a very famous man, I guess. So this is on the one hand, of course, it is possible to point to certain directions where global governance should go, but it's, of course, extremely difficult then to be very concrete how this should be look like and how it could be achieved and how everyone can be convinced to accept it. But in terms of general directions, I would say, deriving from the deficiencies that we talked about, global governance institutions should aim at incorporating all the stakeholders more systematically. They should become more open. They should look essentially for ways to increase their legitimacy, to increase in that way also their acceptance on the societal level at home in all countries. In that sense, it is the task to be more open, to be more integrative, not to be just a reflection of the power interests of the major states. That would be one thing. And the other thing, of course, is deriving from this fragmentation issue, that there should be also institutional places where the different policies are coordinated, where they are brought together, and where people and decision makers look how they affect each other and whether they affect each other negatively. So there should be the attempt to create some elements of meta-governance, those places where the different regimes are coordinated with each other.
Professor Zürn, thank you so much for joining us today here at the German Development Institute in Bonn.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.